What's up, everybody? Back with more. Yes, Your Grace. Sorry it's been so long since I've uploaded an episode of this. I haven't forgotten about it. The Queen wanted to see you, Your Grace. She's got to wait in line, though. North Post was crawling with Radovian scum, Your Grace. We managed to dispatch most of them. Good man. Good man. Your Grace, I'm starting to think that perhaps you are involved. What am I saying? Why would I say this? Why would you tell me someone you know that they know? I better leave. I can leave, right? Stop taking from your own supply there, my guy. With the Radovian post gone, I think we are ready for the wedding, Your Grace. You get away! I don't trust you. Father, Lorsulia, you finally came out. Can you please come and meet me at the wall when you get a chance? I wanted to talk to you. Of course, I will see you there. She's gonna push me off. She's gonna push me off and kill me. The cat's got a gun. This is gonna waste me right then and there. Your Grace, I came here to ask you for your help. My father is very sick with fever. Help me, please. He is as pale as a ghost, and he shakes and sweats all the time. We have tried treating the fever with cold water and a poultice of butter, onion, and garlic. So you're basting him. You're basting him like a turkey. Delicious. We've given him concoction of wormwood and mint. Egads. We even tried letting the bad blood with leeches. I'm afraid he might not last another night. Have you tried cocaine? Your Grace, if we had a court witch available, she could handle these diseases. That's true. You should put word out that we are looking for one. As for your father? It should be enough for you to buy medicine, or to pay a healer. Emir can heal him. He's expensive, but this will be enough. Thank you, Your Grace. I know. I'm kinda awesome. Oops. Apparently it was not the map I wanted. Oh wow, there's a lot of talking to do here. Start in the garden. Your Grace, how you doing? You're a king, so why do you listen to the man in the council chamber, Father? Well, he's a king too, you know. But you're a better king. He should listen to you. Yes, yes. Keep your voice down, Potato Head. Yes, Father. We're almost ready for the wedding. It looks like it's going to be quite a banquet. Yeah, for you it will, not for Lorsulia. I still can't believe she's leaving. Hopefully she can learn to be friends with Prince Ivo. I don't think she wants to. I know. I wish we had more time to find a prince. But this is the way it has to be. May the force be with you. Excuse me, I'm just gonna hide behind this bush. Okay. Curious. Lady Ada invited her, warning of a thief to pretend to be a merchant. She described him as someone who doesn't stand out from the crowd, wearing a green shirt and a hat. The king is sure to keep an eye out for him. I don't remember that description of the thief, but you do you, boo-boo. What's up, my guy? Did you find anything yet? Are those books of any use? Healing fever. How to prevent dysentery. Something about malaria. All of these are useless. Well, it doesn't sound useless to me. You're just a bum. How's your wife? I haven't seen Paloma in years. Does the illness persist? Why are you so curious about her? Yes, she is still sick. Otherwise, I wouldn't even be here. But like I told you already, it's none of your business.
You're in my castle. My castle, you butthead.
How's your son? What's there to say? I have always royal blood, and I pay enough for his masters to ensure that he's at least half as smart as I am. Can't you just leave me alone, Eric? I'm trying to focus here. I'll be in the throne room if you need me. Read as much as you like. Yeah, and I'm gonna take a dump on your chest while you're sleeping, you freaking butthead. Apparently, there's still stuff I can talk to you about. We're almost ready for the wedding. We were preparing for this for weeks. We booked a florist, I bought throne decorations, we'll have a live band. There was no need, I just wanted it to be over and done with. Who cares about some stupid decorations? It's the vows that are important. I hate weddings. People forget what they are really about. Oh. Well, it's gonna be quite a party either way. I'll see you there. Yeah. Why are you such a... like... party pooper? Did Yellis and Baravia resolve their wars yet? What were they fighting about again? Land? Witchcraft? I don't know, and I don't care to find out. I have my own problems. Is everything alright in Haugus? I've always wanted to visit your beautiful town. Why don't you? Go and see for yourself what it's like. Rather than this rat hole.
Why are you so negative? You are so... I'm gonna talk to my wife before I go talk to my daughter. You are such a negative Nancy.
Uh-oh, they're gonna make me pick a dress. Darling. How are the wedding preparations? Everything is ready. Apart from one last thing. Choosing a dress. I'll let you do the honors.
Oh,
I kind of, you know, this last one's, it's a little too much. You know, this last one's a little too much, but this first one's a little too plain. You know, it is my daughter, you know, she's getting married. I got to do something for her. So we're going to go with this one. This is a middle ground gown. Nothing special, but for 25 pieces of gold, we can't expect too much. So what do you think? The puffy one, yes? I'm broke, babe. Let me have a think. The puffy one. I'll be back. Let me run. Let me escape. I mean, I look so good. Maybe you're old too, my guy. Well, it looks like we're gonna have to... pick this one. This is obviously not an option, then why'd you put it out? I found it in the chest of my old clothes, it even smells. It won't cost a coin, but you... well, what everything? So the puffy one. I wanted to click on the dress. That boy's gonna be 50 gold, man. Decorated piece of art. Isn't it beautiful? 50 gold is nothing for such elegance. What do you say then? This is the... that's expensive. Don't you worry about the cost. The bank said they will help us fund the dress, so it's almost free. How will that work exactly? Oh, I don't know. They will spread the cost or something. Don't worry about it. It won't cost us anything until the wedding is over. No. I'm not... no. 50 gold on a dress? Insanity. We can't afford it. We're broke. Well, guess what? She gets the plain dress. Yeah, you shouldn't have. Peace. It's just a dress. She's gonna wear it for a day. She'll be fine. What's up, my guy? Oh. Okay. Good work, Mudgy. You want a pie? I got a pie. Alright. What's up? What's going on? Come over here. Pet the cat. Bop, 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 bop. Cat petted. Okay, one moment. Got all sorts of stuff going on right now. Meow. Okay, pet. Oh, it's you. You asked me to come talk to you here. Why are you talking to me like that? I'm sorry I shouted at you, father. I didn't mean it when I called you stupid. I just wish things were different. I just wish I'd spent the past couple of days being with you, not angry at you. I know, Daron. I know. I love you, father. I love you more than anything in this world, Luli. Aw, I know. You hate it when I call you that, but you're still my Luli. It's alright, Papa. I'll miss you calling me Luli.
Your mother has prepared one hell of a wedding. Yes, I'd better get ready before she finds me. I'll see you at the party.
Oh, it's about to be lit. My wife's gonna hate me forever because we broke and I couldn't afford a fancier dress.
Is there, can I walk faster? Oh, that's how I get to that. That's how I, okay.
Let's get to the wedding.
I mean, we're all set.
Let's do this, y'all.
The King of Davern and Atana make an alliance treaty to join forces against Radovia. Oh, I bought all the upgrades. Look at this. Ahem. I'm overwhelmed by the beauty of my, new wife here. I'll enjoy the company, I'm sure. And, damn it. Can someone help him? Can someone help the young prince? It's just nervousness, that's all. Oh, no need, I'm up. Like I said, company, my wife, yes, here's to that. Forgive me, I am father. Should I make some kind of speech? I wasn't sure what to say, I didn't offend you. You look, that's an interesting choice of dress, by the way. Oh. He's still a better pick than Radovia. You don't want to know what the other option was. What? There was another option? Luckily, it's not an option anymore, my darling. We'll discuss this later. Mm-hmm. I will be on my way, if you will excuse me. Talus. About the Radovians. This seals the deal, Eric. You get the army, I get full access to the archives. I mean, you've been in there, so... I wasn't sure if you would honor our bargain, Eric. Are you trying to insult me? Don't take it personally, Eric. Your archives may prove useful, but I haven't found what I need just yet. I'm just relieved you came through. And the party went on. Everyone was busy eating fancy food, drinking the finest wines, and I couldn't finish what the last bit said. I looked for him everywhere. I've stirred up every pot, even in the kitchen. Don't worry, we'll find him, said Ani. This salad looks surprisingly flavorsome. What is it? A Kaladi's recipe? Ha! Did you see her dress? She could have worn a rag and you wouldn't have been able to tell the difference. These snails are extremely undercooked. Fuh. What snails? That's not part of the menu. Smudge! The party went better than anyone expected. Well, except for the little girl who just lost her pet snail. Look, listen, I think I've wasted... I've spent enough time with the guests. I really need to get back to the archives, so if you don't mind, I'll take my leave, Eric. Talus, ha, your grace. Leaving so early? Dose, drink at least one more with us. Something bad's about to happen. See? Perfect timing, your grace. Eh. Will I get some peace after that? To the young couple. Until the ill-fated toast, that is.
I got the black long paw.
Eric, do something.
Send for the doctor. Well, don't just stand there, idiots. You heard the king. Go.
Talus was on the ground before anyone had a chance to react.
He is not... Is he? Father?
Your grace. Father.
Oh no, he's stone cold dead. I... How could you? Eric, how could you ever allow for this to happen? Eric, you have accommodated us in your castle, which we were grateful for, but this? This is beyond our beliefs. You have failed as a host and are responsible for the events of tonight. The King of Atana, Talus, is dead. Ivo, you're Talus's only son. You have no choice but to take the burden of the crown upon yourself. Go ahead, Ivo. Eric, I can't believe this. You leave me no choice. As new king of Atana, my first order is to withhold the armies that my father promised to you, and I will not be paying for your agents. Eric, the King of Davern, you're responsible for Talus' death unless otherwise can be proven upon a royal trial. Until then, Davern will not receive support from Atana. Lord Sulia, pack your things. We're taking my father home. Wait, no, you can't do that. Your Grace, the wedding is over. The vows were said, the marriage still stands. Have courage, my darling. Oh. To hire an agent, select the button with their name. You'll see the cost added. Summary bullet.
Well, hot damn. Hot damn.
Well, that really complicates things, doesn't it? We kind of need that army to fight the Radovians. Well, I guess we'll have to figure it out in the next episode. Hope y'all like it. Comment, subscribe, dislike. I hope y'all have a wonderful day, and I hope to catch you